then somewhere lions are happy and lions. And see then somewhere they're happy with all these animals. They can never hide because they're many. They're very noisy as well. They keep making that noise. Ah. When you see the young ones, which is the ones are straight, those are actually, they were born in January, February this year. So every year, 500,000 calves are born. And they're all born farther down, south in the Serengeti. About 70% of them, because 75% of the wildebeest migrate to the south. 25% doesn't migrate, but they doesn't stay in the pack. They go further north.
Hmm.
So they all calf at the same time. So this is now the breeding season. This is the mating season. Yeah, they're all born, yeah, they'll be born in January, February. So the thing about them is that all the calves, they're all born within 2 weeks, within a few weeks of each other. Within 2-3 weeks, all the calves will be born at the same time. And that is the reason is that it's usually to confuse predators, because if predators kill a few, a majority will survive because they need a short time to be safe. It only takes about 3 to 10 minutes for a calf to stand and run.
Wow.
When you see a day old, it is nearly as fast as the adults.
Wow.
Yeah, so they will have the same chances of survival. And then also, like, there will be a lot of afterbirth, a lot of placenta that will keep the hyenas and things busy. So, and that helps the, you know, babies to grow.
Ah.
That's why they're successful. And something else which is very unique with the wildebeest, that the wildebeest moms are able to adapt each other calves. So in the event there is a mom somewhere that has lost a calf, and there is a calf somewhere that has lost a mom, they are able to adapt each other. That's why they are successful. That's why they are many. They go into a sheep pen and kill the whole flock, eat one or two, and leave the rest dead. So in the morning, we have like 100 sheep all dead there. Yeah, so they're quite destructive. We also hate the wildebeest because of the disease they transmit to cows during their calving period. There's a disease called the malignant cattle fever, which is transmitted when cows lick the afterbirth or the placenta of the wildebeest. They get the disease. But have you seen that, have you realized that most zebras look fat, they all, even stallions sometimes, you think they're pregnant. It's because of the gas. You know, zebras, because of their diet. Thank you. the videos. See all these people doing here. Will blend in here, leopards, even cheetahs. It's hard to see them. Although cheetahs doesn't like the long grass because they can't run better. Mm-hmm. anaanza kutembea wasee. Anatembea tembea. Amelala hapa kichaka. Nzuri sana.
There you go.
The food on the trip. Really mean relax. It's more relaxed like a lab. Thank you. See the Tulia, that's the leopard food. So they were mating, they're not, leopards are solitary. So unless they're mating or they have a baby, otherwise they go by themselves. Edo, kainalo.
Yeah.
Am kainalo?
Yeah.
Ayila naim.
Yeah.
Ee.
Naim.
Ito dua di mabaya mi kito kaya ay boyong kisme. Nego na ramang adi.
I don't believe them.
Long tusks. Very good. We call it with a toilet seat.
Yeah.
It's got a ring on the back. This one has got a white band.
Yeah.